To this transfer meeting with Viviana, and I'll let you read the title yourselves, and I'm sure you've read it. You're going to take about 20 to 30 minutes to present your research, and then you'll be asked to, you know, if you have any questions or any comments, and then you will leave the room and we'll do the. Is that correct, Mark?
That's perfect, right? Yeah.
Okay. So it's all over to you, Viviana.
Thank you very much. Thank you for attending my transfer talk today. My name is Viviana Mastidas. I'm going to present my research in the field of smart cities. The title of my research is an Archimedes extension for modeling the alignment of services and information in smart city architectures. My supervisors are Dr. Marcus Helfer and Dr. Maria Besbradic. So this is the agenda for today. We are going through the motivation, the theoretical background, the problem, and the research questions, and finally, I'm going to present the research methodology and the results and future work. So we know that smart cities are urban spaces where advanced and novel services are offered to the citizens in order to improve their quality of life. I had the opportunity to work with Limerick during 1 year and a half, and I found that Limerick has a strategic plan to become a smart city. So they offer different services, such as the football counter service. So this service aims to improve the way by which people can commute by walking or cycling in the city. This other service, a whole air quality service from the environment domain, aims to provide the air quality data to the public. And the other service, the road monitoring service, is a service which aims to detect the level of heavy rain, snow, or flood in the city and inform or warn the different vehicles and cyclists. And we said that these different services are built separately, and we need to align what is important for them. We know that it's not easy, this alignment, because the services, these services, have to respond to different goals from multiple stakeholders. For example, from city authorities, from citizens, from service providers, but also these services are supported by information, by different technologies, different applications of our services. But we are talking about smart cities. So in smart cities, we have large-scale urban environments with these end systems are dynamic and heterogeneous. So this alignment between the services and information is difficult. And I found in practice that, as I mentioned, these services are normally built in one specific domain. Imagine if we could integrate these services. For example, we can have the best way to walk for walking or cycling in the city, and with the best air quality, and with the best street conditions. So this integration is important for the smart cities. However, as I mentioned, in the practice and also in the literature, I found that these services are built separately. As a consequence, we have alignment issues, we have silos of information, and also we have some knowledge that is not shared between the different stakeholders in those domains. So I'm talking about the alignment, and the main output of my research is an extension of the Archimedes metamodel to achieve the alignment between services and information. But what does mean alignment? So alignment defines how organizations can use information technology to achieve their goals. And in the 90s, IBM proposed an information systems architecture, and then around 2000, an approach called enterprise architecture emerges to achieve this desired alignment from business and IT. The enterprise modeling supports the enterprise architecture because in the enterprise modeling is the process of creating enterprise architecture models to represent the current and the future state of organizations. And in enterprise modeling, a core element is the use of a modeling language. So nowadays, we have that Archimedes is the most prominent enterprise modeling language that we can use to visualize, to analyze, and to express the different components in organization environments. Archimedes is based on standards such as IEEE for architectural descriptions. That's why I'm using this language in my research, and also I'm using this language in the Limerick Enterprise Architecture Project. So I'm working on this project, and this project aims to apply enterprise architecture to illustrate how enterprise architecture can address the different alignment issues in Limerick to design, to support the different services that they offer. However, I found in practice that to ensure this alignment between the services and information is necessary to consider some other specifics from the domain application of the smart city. So we need to consider, for example, as I explained in my first slide, those domains are important for the integration of the different end systems, for sharing the knowledge between the different stakeholders. So, but in Archimedes, there is not an accurate form of presenting those domains. So based on my literature review that I'm going to present in the next slide, and based on the work with the practitioners, I found that traditional business IT alignment present different concepts and relationships to achieve or to address this alignment between business and IT. However, these traditional concepts don't consider the specific concepts of smart city. Archimedes language provides the means to link the different architectural layers. However, this language don't provide a precise form for representing these specifics in smart cities. And I also reviewed the meta models for smart cities, and I found that these meta models are based on information and technology aspects. And these meta models don't consider the alignment between the services and the information. So that's why we need an extension of the Archimedes meta model to consider those specifics of smart cities. I also review the smart city architectures to establish how these architectures address the alignment between the different architectural layers. So this review follows a concept-centric approach for systematic literature reviews proposed by Webster and Watson. I collect approximately 60 high quality journal and conference papers, and I found from three different layers of the smart city architectures which components are important in each of these layers. For example, in the service layer, I found that the city services, the objectives, the strategies, the stakeholders are important for smart cities in those architectures. And it's important because we can support the smart city vision, and we can improve the way that they make decisions in the city. The information perspective includes components such as monitoring applications, software services, data entities, which are important to support the automation and realization of those city services. And the technology perspective, I found in my review different components, and these components are infrastructure, software and hardware infrastructure to support the smart city operation. And these authors propose different architectures, and they provide some of these components. And I found in my review that most of these architectures are based on information and technology aspects. And it's easy to see how the information is linked or is connected with the technology layer. For example, we can see how we can connect a gateway with a application, with a monitoring application through, for example, an application protocol, so such as HTTP, REST, or something like this. So, but in these architectures, it's easy to see this connection. However, these architectures don't focus in this perspective and don't present the links explicitly between the service and information. So here we found a knowledge gap, which is the lack of alignment between these two layers. So now we have a problem. The problem is the lack of alignment between these two different layers. So how we can address this problem? So this hypothesis aims to address that problem, and the hypothesis says the service and information layers can be aligned by extending the Archimedes language with the specific concepts of smart cities to ensure that the services meet the needs of the citizens. And I define the main research question, which aims to identify what are those specifics, what exactly we need for the alignment between these two layers in smart city architectures. And the first sub-research question aims to define what are the design principles. So the end output of my research is an Archimedes extension. So how we need to design, how we can design this this extension. So we can use different design principles to ensure this alignment. The second research question aims to identify what are those specifics and what constraints we need to consider in to create the relationship between the different concepts with the existing Archimedes meta model. And the last one aims to apply and evaluate those principles, those specifics, in real scenarios. So the main component of my research is an artifact in a form of an extension metamodel. I choose design sign as an appropriate design research methodology, and I follow with PIFRS, this auto-proposed clear steps to define the problem, to identify the objectives for the step of the design and development, for the evaluation and demonstration, and for the communication first. So it's important to say that this is my current work, and I'm now in the design and development, in the design phase. I have to say also that this methodology is not sequential because we can iterate back, for example, from the demonstration and evaluation to the design phase to improve the design of the artifact. To answer the first research question, if we remember, is what are the design principles to ensure the alignment between services and information? So I'm following some techniques to identify what are these specifics, what are these design principles. So the first technique is the literature review about these design principles. So I found four categories and eight subcategories to represent these design principles. So I also interview people in Limerick City which are involved in the project of smart cities. So I conduct semi-structured interviews, and we were in different meetings with these people, especially with the head of the city, with the data managers, and with the end users. And finally, I have to say that these design principles can be structured in a taxonomy or classified in this way, and then following a method for the taxonomy to construct this final output to answer the first research question. This is an initial version, so at the moment I have this result for the research question one, but my objective is interview also more people and review more papers to validate this first version of the taxonomy and to improve it. So, as we see in the first slide, the domains such as mobility or environment are important for smart cities. And in my literature review, I found that early research says that the successful deployment of individual domains, individual services in separately domains are not enough for making cities smart. So we need to integrate those services and those domains. And more recent research emphasize that smart cities are required to exchange the data between the different end systems across those domains. So in this slide, I presented two examples of Limerick City. So one of is the football counter service and the other one is the weather service, but in Archimedes, there is not a way to represent those domains. But imagine if we have thousands or hundreds of thousands of these services from different domains, how we can model this integration. So from the modeling approach and following the meta model of Archimedes, I identify that those domains, mobility, environment, transportation, can be modeled by using a new concept that I call domain, that represent the city domain. In this way, we know now, for example, to which domain every service belongs. And we can identify, for example, the software services in each domain. And we can share this data, the knowledge between the different actors in the city. If we identify the domain and we identify what are the different relationships, because it's not just establish the domain or the new concept, we have to establish the constraints to create the extension of in Archimedes to consider those specifics of smart cities. But also, I identified at the moment new concepts that I need to validate, and I need to establish what relationship, if these are important or not for practitioners. For example, in the most of the architectures, I found that most of them concern on technology and information aspects, but they don't show how the services, how we can provide the value for the stakeholders with these services. And also, I found that at the level of the information in smart cities, it's important to consider how we can manage these services. If we have thousands of services, how we can, for example, discover those services, and how we can compose those services. So we need other element here that is specific for smart cities. And as a future work, I need to identify if there are more concepts, more specific concepts that I need for achieve this alignment between services and information. And the most important thing here is that those concepts need to be validated with these design principles. So those new concepts have to fulfill each of these design principles to support, to say that that these concepts are addressing the alignment that we define in the first research question. This is one example of how we can integrate or how we can represent using Archimedes meta model those domains. So we have those domains, the mobility and environment, and the services that belongs to those domains, and also we can trace in this diagram, for example, which software services are supporting those domains, which data, and also, for example, if the city, such as Limerick, they collect the data from different sensors, but these sensors provide application programming interfaces for integrate those that information, we know now how these components can be traced from the different city domains. Also, in practice, we can present the information integrating the data collected from the different sensors from the different domains. For example, here we have the number of commuters, but also we said that this number can be affected by the weather conditions. And we can, for example, if one person is planning a trip, this person provides us the planned trip information, and we can integrate this information with the weather forecast, and we can inform this person also the level of pollution in this route. So we can start to integrate. But also, the most important thing to say here is that we are first modeling this integration. It's not considering when this is already developed or already implemented. We have to consider those elements in the modeling phase. As part of my future work, I have to evaluate these principles resulting from the research question one and these specifics resulting from the research question two. So first, I have to map, as I mentioned, to evaluate how those specifics fulfill those design principles. It's important to consider also the feedback of the experts to develop the multiple case study for the evaluation of this proposal. At the end, we are going to have validated principles and concepts as a result of this first evaluation. As part of my future work, I'm considering I'm considering to finish the research question one and two in the process of my research for the next months, and also I consider the publications, the new publications about this specific research, and the evaluation of the proposal as the main output of this research. So the contribution, first I have to say that, as I mentioned, most of the architectures are more focused on information and technology aspects, and we are proposing, I'm proposing something new that is achieved alignment. We know that alignment already exists from business and IT, but business and IT approaches, but they are not considering what is necessary for smart cities, what else we need, because most of the solutions can be technical, but how we are supporting that these solutions are addressing or are achieving the main goals of the smart city. So the design principles are one of the output, the specific concepts as well, and the most important is that we're providing a validated extension of the Archimedes language that other people can use for modeling those services in smart cities. And researchers and practitioners can use the extension of the Archimedes as a comprehensive language and meta model to make more effective design or modeling decisions. This is the list of my publications, and I have to say thank you.
Okay, thank you, Viviana, for a very interesting presentation. Now, any comments from the floor? Any questions at all?
In your experience, have you found that it's common or possible to have these service and IT layers misaligned in cities? Have you encountered such cases?
Yeah, in Limerick we found that. So just for one of these services, for example, for football counter service, even if we know that the business IT alignment, business IT approaches can address this alignment, they are not considering this. So we are trying to apply enterprise architecture now and say, okay, we have first to model those services and how we can improving the way that they can integrate the data, because the most of the problems in Limerick and in other cities is that they are building these services separately.
Have you ever observed any problem with, for example, current football counter service in Limerick City? From this point of view, that I mean, the needs for a smart city point of view.
Most of the services that they propose are aligned with the main goals of the city, so they already have a list of initiatives for building those services. However, in practice, when they are to contract, for example, and to buy different sensors, those sensors use different technologies. And the problem in some cases is the integration between these technologies. But we can solve it. From the point of view of the technology, we have already many architectures that say how we can integrate this. The problem is when we don't know how these end systems and these end services are achieving and are helping the city to achieve their main goals.
Thanks.
Okay. Any further?
Yeah,
all right, great.
Thank you, Viviane, for your presentation. Very interesting. I just want to add that, you know, I used to cycle a lot, for example, and I get really, really annoyed when I put a destination and Google reroutes me through a very hilly zones of the city center. So not city center, but in general in Dublin. So I get really annoyed because of that. And there is definitely a need for a smarter services based, for example, on the geographical, on the relief of cities. But I have a slightly different question, and that is, who do you envisage to be the user or the consumer of your research? Because, I mean, it will definitely provide to the citizens better services, but the citizens doesn't care about, for example, Archimedes. So who is the consumer of your research?
Okay, so in the cities, in the smart city projects, always there is a person who has to manage the projects. So for this person, it's important to know how the main goals of his or her strategy is achieving with different solutions. But I'm proposing something. The Archimedes extension is something that the users, such as architects, such as designers, can use for modeling those services. And in Limerick City, for example, the architecture repository that we have now contains multiple diagrams, multiple models that can help for the development. So it's not just to use the Archimedes language, it's also to use the final models to guide the development or implementation, and even, for example, for any discussion with people in Limerick, we use the models and we know, for example, what is the current or future state of these services.
Okay, so it's something like a mapping between different domains.
So different users can use the results, resulting models, but the designers are exactly the people who can use the Archimedes extension.
Oh, thank you.
Any other questions, comments? No? Okay, then I'll have to ask you to leave your colleague now to listen to the examiner's questions, and thank you very much for coming along. Thank you.